It's working. Thank you. Hi everyone, my name is Adewale Oluyinka. I'm from Nigeria and I've been working as a developer for over 6 years now with various technologies. Before I did this presentation, I did like a test presentation with a couple of friends. So just to get feedback, and one of the things that they told me is that I was not funny. And so I decided to come up with some jokes. So even if the joke is lame, please pretend to laugh or smile. You know, I'll take it there. Okay, and I know we've done this before, so just for me to help me to make this presentation better, please, who or how many of us have used React in production? Okay, 3. Wow. I was hoping there would be more guys that would, you know, answer questions from the crowd, like, you know, the other presenters are. But yeah, it's cool. So the rest of us are, I guess, we've either tried React or we have not used React at all. So my goal today is to somehow woo you into to start using React, just like Jack in Titanic would Rose to start using him until he died. Well, nobody's going to die in this case. So, for those of us that have experience using React, I hope to add more knowledge to you, and then so that you can continue to stay and use React. So, I will start with the cool things about React. The cool things, one of the coolest things about React is the concept of React itself. And the first is the component. And we've seen something similar in Angular. It pretty much works the same way. In React, the component is at the top of the pyramid. It's to use a component, simply extend a React component. And you have an instance of that component. The next is a state. It's simply the internal state to a component. And the next is a prop or props. This is the external state to a component. And please forgive me, I know there are more technical definitions, but I try to make this as simple as possible. And the next is a mapper, which is the HTML thing in when you write, when you render your components. And then the next is DOM, which is the documents and elements within the documents. React is as far as I know, it's the best language for handling DOM manipulation, meaning you as a developer, you do not need to write to manipulate DOM. React does all that for you. It's part of its concept and it's been optimized, so you don't need to worry about the speed of using it. React also has the concept of one-way data flow, meaning data flows down to an element and data flows up, an action flows up. When we get to some snippets, I will show you exactly what that means. And React has also led to very good framework approaches. Some of us might be familiar with Redux or Flux, and so many other libraries that exist using React's design approach. React has changed how developers work. The other cool thing about React is it comes with a free integrated performance monitoring tool. So all you have to do is include this library in your work. And when you, of course, it has many functions, but one of the most useful ones is when you call print wasted. What it does is it looks for where your components is being rendered without the state being changed, because that's the way React works. It's supposed to change or give a fresh view to the user if the state of the component has changed. So this will also help you to eliminate useless code in your, or deal with it in some other ways if you prefer. Then React also has what is called server-side rendering. Basically allows you to pre-render an initial state of React component server-side before it gets it. The traditional way would be the browser will load the scripts necessary for the React app to work, or for a JavaScript app to work. But with React, you can implement this, and then some of those codes will be sent to the user. Then it makes it seem faster. Then there's also Create React App. It's a CLI. And for the demo that I'll be showing later, this is what I used. I think the cool thing for me about it is you don't need to do any setup. You don't need to wire anything in Webpack or use Gulp or whatever it is. It might be a pain to set up. And the current disadvantage, or one of the major current disadvantages that it has now, or maybe yesterday, I don't know if they fix it today, is that it doesn't come with test configuration. So if you want to do that, you can also do that, even but that means you have to kind of run a command that takes away the automatic build system. Then the next thing, React also has about 50,000 stars on GitHub, and it was open source about 3.5 years ago. So it is growing, and it's growing tremendously, and it is something that you will want to check out, at least use it in some application and see how it works. So where it all began. React.js began with a Facebook framework called Bot.js, and that's a sample code. I hope we can see it. And, well, maybe it's not really needed now, but from this is where most the features, or the legendary features of APIs from React came from, like the render method, the create class, and the rest. This is where they all came. But as Facebook developers develop more complicated applications, these more sophisticated applications rather, the Bot.js library became more complicated. So it's like all bad relationships, you know, you are sure that you have found the one, until a couple of months later you realize it's not so simple. So the same way, Facebook realized that they needed to move on to something else. So they started working on Fast.js, and it was a side project, and it ran for 6 months. And this is all, this from Fast.js is where most of React's fundamentals came from, including props and states. And in 2012, Fast.js was completed. It was imported into the React library, sorry, the Facebook code base. And it was renamed FBot. I don't know why, but later they decided that they were going to rename it React again. Airboat wasn't so cool, so React broke up the fight between both Fast.js and Bot, and they have React. at this point, React didn't have JSX, and the React library started, before BoltJS, before FastJS rather, Facebook had been using XHP, and XHP is defined as an extension of PHP, which augments the syntax of the language to both make your front-end code easier to understand and help you avoid cross-site scripting attacks. In simpler words, it helps you to write XML in your PHP. So, since Facebook owned both XHP and JS and React at the time, it was pretty easy for them to steal from them from Facebook and then use it for Facebook. It's kind of similar to the way Apple stole the iPhone 6 and renamed it iPhone 7. That was a joke. Okay, so, and React was born. At this point, React had all it needed to work. But as we all know, software is never completed. So when Facebook bought Instagram in 2012, they decided to build Instagram websites completely in React. And for this to be possible, although the idea was already in play, but they never really did it, they had to decouple React from Facebook, and it was then that it became open source. Okay, and that is the history of React and where it is today. In the future, React has positioned itself, and the React development team has positioned themselves in a very good place to have a rapid development for the React framework, or for the React library rather. They have a GitHub repo called React Future. This is where, as a developer, we can contribute, we can create pull requests or raise issues and contribute to development of React. And I included this sample code for those of us that are using React. We will be familiar that it's not so easy to write this undo click callback for a click event. You will have to include .bind and this. And this is one of the suggestions from this developer, that it's really not necessary to start using other libraries like auto bind or something to do this. So, let's work some monsters. This is working some monsters. It's a demo app a short one that I created just to show the concepts of React in play and help us, you know, be more familiar with it. It has the main component called an app. Then it has this core component. It has the rules component, and this is just a snippet to show how you can use the components within the app component. So, and if you want to take a look at the code afterwards, I will show you the details. And the way when you are playing the game, or when you're working some monster, or when the score is being recorded, you have the score, score data is being passed down to the score component. So this is a demonstration of the one-way data binding that I spoke about earlier. And it's pretty common all over React framework. You're gonna see something similar to this whenever you're building React. And when you click on something or where you watch something, the action is being sent up to the app, then the app handles the process or the logic behind. And now it's time for a demo. Okay. It's just a simple app where you click on start, it gives you several monsters. Well, that was not a monster, but if you miss a monster, you get a negative, but if you were able to whack the monster, you get a positive. If you whack a baby, you get a negative. You know, that's the simple one. The simplest, I think it's the simplest game that you can ever play, just whack something. And it's pretty fun and cool. Okay, I'll go back to the presentation now. Oh, one more thing I need to show, just how it works. So this score is being, the data of the score is being passed down as a prop. And the score components just displays the data, that's all it does. And then when you click on the monster, the action goes to the app component, and then it updates the prop of the score and passes it down to the score again. So you have the basic and one of the most common things that you keep doing in React, working here, you have a component, you have a state, you have a prop, you have DOM manipulation, and you have one way data binding in play, all in this one app. Okay, so what is React from, you know, all the history, the code, the concepts, and all that? I came up with a few definitions, and some definitions I came up with, some I got from various resources. React.js can be seen as an optimization for DOM manipulation that lets developers write web applications with very little code. React is an open source JavaScript library providing a view for data rendered as HTML. React is a declarative, efficient, and flexible JavaScript library for building user interfaces. Some of us might be familiar with declarative or functional programming, but the typical way that we write code, we don't typically do it with in the declarative or in the functional way. But this is one of the things that make modularization or compartmentalization efficient in React. And finally, the simplest definition that you get when you go to the React website is it's a JavaScript library for building user interfaces. Thank you. So, do you have any questions, please? I use Windows command, but I try to reduce our complexity and reduce time and focus on the point of driving the concepts and the reasons why you should use React than the things that we do normally as developers.
Have you used Angular?
Yes.
And what do you think between those two? Well, if you did the demonstration on React, you probably choose React, but...
When I use Angular, I use it when React wasn't very popular, I guess. So it's what I'm doing at this moment is I've started to use React. I see the advantages and the support that is also growing for React. So at this point, I can't compare both of them really. React did really well last year, than Angular given, but I can't say that I prefer to use one over the other. Personally, I'm much more of a flexible developer than, just saying that, oh, I love this or I hate this or this is better than this in so many ways. They both have their markets, I would say that, but I don't have a preference,
But if you have to start your own project right now, you will start with Angular or with?
With React.
And what would you prefer to the newcomers?
Sorry?
What would you prefer to the newcomers of this Angular and React? Would you
to the new what?
Newcomers, the people who are new to the web.
Okay, the newcomers, okay.
So, I don't have time for both of them, so what did you say? You say just check out the React.
Now, if you have a choice, yes, check out both. Then, and for some people, it's the developing in Angular might it's really highly opinionated. So, just check out both and decide which one you want to use. I would really encourage you that you try both of them. I use both of them for different projects. Given I'm not using Angular at the moment, I'm using React, but you should try both of them, then make up decision yourself.
While learning and using React, what was one thing that was annoying you? What would you change?
When I learned React, React itself wasn't a problem. I joined a team that was working on a project and they were using React. And the problem I had with the team was I found so many design concepts and ways they were developing that weren't traditional way of use, or at least it wasn't similar to what Facebook described in how to use React. So my frustration was that as developers, it's easy for us to go back to the way that we used to develop, change some things, make things suit us. That was the frustration I had. I personally don't think I had any problem with React.
And
I think Yes, you can use React in as a, definitely as a single page component. But one other thing, I've never used it with .NET in that way, so I wouldn't really know if it's really designed for that that way. So does that answer your question? Yes, it's to find out. Yes, exactly. Thank you. Thank you. Yes.
Which libraries do you use for storing states?
I've worked with Redux. That's as far as React is concerned. Yes.
But for example, for which project you suggest to use Redux, and for which project you suggest to use Flask?
I can't make that suggestion, sorry. I can't make that. I think you really have to find out. I read about Flux when I was also using Redux. I think as creators, they both, and as competitors, they both, you know, say that this is better than this and that is better than that. So I think it's really left to the developer. I've never tried different renders, no. Sorry? Oh, okay.
If you have more questions, please come to Adewale. Let's finish. Thank you very much.